Hello, what's up guys, it's Dekosaur. So in case you've watched my previous video, tuning the Ryzen 9950X performance by changing some settings in the BIOS, I mentioned that some MSI boards have now a new feature found in the OSC tab that is called Memory Timing Preset. All you need to do is enable this high efficiency option and then choose from the memory timing presets between Relax, Balance, Tighter, and Tightest. Now in case you don't know what memory timings mean, Random Access Memory, or RAM, has timings that manage different operations such as reading, writing, and copying. Each operation has specific timings and they are measured in clock cycles and could be converted in nanoseconds. Now given that DDR5 has a higher frequency, it currently comes with a higher latency trade-off. This is because with higher frequency, you are already doing operations faster, so tightening the memory timings too much can cause an instability. And to lower them at higher speeds, you may need to increase the RAM voltage, which in turn increases the generated heat. However, the best way will be that as the components behind it mature and become more efficient, we'll start to see higher frequency and lower memory timings for DDR5 kits at a decent voltage. With that aside, MSI has introduced this new feature to improve your current RAM performance by reducing the non-SPD timing. So in this video, we'll check each mode and put them to test so you can see the difference it makes. The memory model I'm using is by Gscale and it's running in Expo profile at 6000 MHz. Each stick is 16 GB for a total of 64 GB. I believe this feature could work on many kits, not exclusively this one, but it may not boot or be stable at all preset levels. And here in Zen timings, we can see the difference between each preset. It made changes in 9 non-SPD related timings. For example, when we switch to Relax, we immediately see changes in timings like TRTB, TRRDS, TRRDL, TWR, and TREFI. As we go to Balance, default changes to 28 from 32, as well as TWRTS and TWRTL. Moving to Tighter, it changes the TRFC. And finally, on the Tightest preset, TRFC lowers to 500. It's worth noting again that these are the non-SPD timing. It didn't change the main SPD timing, since those are more likely to cause instability but will yield a higher impact on performance. But I guess it didn't do so, as the SPD timings need to be adjusted carefully, while non-SPD timings are less likely to cause instability if too weak. The first thing I did was benchmarking the preset using the IDA64 memory test. And here are the results. For read speed, we went from 77,500 to 80,600 on the Tightest preset, so a 3000 MB increase. For write speed, we saw over 5000 MB improvement. For copy speeds, it was a 1000 MB improvement. And finally, latency dropped from 74.3 to 64.2 nanoseconds on the Tightest option, giving the lowest latency even compared to the other presets. So on papers, our results are quite appealing. We can also see that as soon as we switch to the Relax preset, most of the performance uplift happens. So what I mean is that even if your system couldn't boot at the Tightest setting, going with Relax will still give you a decent improvement. An essential thing to do when adjusting memory timings is to ensure it's error-free. I tested the Tightest preset using this RAM test app. Just because it boots to Windows and doesn't crash doesn't mean it's stable. Small errors within memory may make the system operable, but they can backfire by reducing performance, as the CPU and Windows have to work by handling those errors, which slows things down. So what I did is running it for an hour. This app is fast at spotting RAM errors since it runs in multi-thread. So you can see here, I have no errors at all. Now since this app is paid only, you can alternatively test it using IDA64 stability test, even in a trial version. Just make sure to check the stress system memory option. IDA64 is also good at spotting RAM errors, so make sure to run it for at least an hour. I ran mine for an hour and another one while recording this clip, and it seems quite stable. Now let's jump into some gaming benchmark. I've prepared 5 games running at 1080p on low graphics settings to ensure we aren't GPU bottleneck. In Cyberpunk 2077, we saw a notable jump in performance, around 20 average FPS from the default to Tightest. You can also see that GPU utilization has increased, indicating that our CPU and RAM are working more than before. And so is our low FPS has improved. Here is the chart. In all memory timing presets, we saw a great performance overall, about a 10% increase. Next up is Horizon Zero Dawn. We also see a good improvement in FPS across the board. In some instances, the jump was again as big as 20 FPS, similar to Cyberpunk, along with a decent improvement in low FPS and up to a 10% increase in GPU use. Things are rather too well, and I never expected such a positive outcome just by changing a tiny option in BIOS. Looking at the chart, we see up to 294 average FPS in tightest compared to 278 on default. Now, even though the tightest has scored the highest, the other presets are still close behind, with the default one being the furthest back. Now let's move to Wukong benchmark, and here we see a similar improvement, better GPU utilization, higher averages, and better low FPS. All of the memory timing presets profiles has performed well. Also in Metro Exodus, we got better performance with up to a 10 FPS improvement, which translates to roughly 5%. Finally, in Red Dead Redemption 2, we also see a 10 FPS improvement. In this final chart, we can see all the 9 memory timings values from when they were on default versus to what it changed them in the tightest preset. I also did a bit of research on the possible impact on each one on gaming. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope it was useful. I recommend if you have an MSI board and have this feature available, check it out and let me know in the comments if it worked and what kind of gains you got with it. Personally speaking, I think it's smart of MSI to have implemented such a feature to gain free performance. And as the saying goes, it's the little things that count. Also, before forgetting, and in case you haven't, make sure to watch my other videos on tuning the Ryzen 9950X in BIOS, as well as my other ones for 7950X 3D, 7950X, and 5950X that explore more CPU related features such as the BBO and the curve optimizer, and also the curve shaper for the 9950X, which gave us about a 10% improvement in CPU performance. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to TricoSword to be on the know of everything new. Thanks for watching, and see you guys in the next one. Peace out.